Hey, high school sports fans, welcome to 806 High School Sports Connection. My name is Victor Hatchett with my co-host Jason Pearson.
Yes, sir.
And we're about to give you the 2015 Tour Day Preview.
Yes.
Hey, Jason, it's been a long year waiting, man. We've been waiting for this. Give us the rundown on 2-6-A.
2-6-A, before we get started, don't forget the show is powered by 806hssc.com. Go there, get a membership, $6 a month, $30 a year. Highlights 3 days early, free high-res photos, all exclusive content, videos. Go there and subscribe. Thank you very much for your support. All right, let's look at 2-6-A for 2015.
Wow.
Coach of the year in that district, obviously to me, is Brad Davis from Friendship.
Yes.
Does this thing every year.
Yes,
don't forget in 6-A that the top two seeds this year from now on in the playoffs get home field advantage.
Yes.
That's huge.
That is.
Especially for these districts that cross play El Paso teams.
Yeah.
So they'll get an El Paso team at home, but the other two seeds will be going to El Paso.
Wow.
What a long drive. But okay, let's look at, to me, the predicted order of finish. Let's jump. Number one, I'm sure maybe you agree with me, is Friendship Tigers.
Yes.
Their player to watch of many players is Ronald Ewok.
Yes.
As you say, he stepped down and had 1,180 yards and 15 touchdowns, splitting time with Grant Sandercox.
Yes.
And that's unbelievable stats when you're splitting time.
Yes, it is.
Got Hayden Harrison, a linebacker. Bryce Kaiser, safety. Roger Curl, a cornerback. They got a lot of players. Tristan Kennard steps in for quarterback, taking off for Parkin Bingham.
Yes.
To me, that'll be the question. And not a bad question. This, I think if he steps in and just controls the offense, Friendship is going back to the second round.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe seeing Abilene Cooper again. Hopefully a better result. But as far as this district, they're going to win this district. They had a couple of good games last year in the district. They beat Tascosa by 1 point. But the other games were not that close.
Yeah.
So give me a rundown on Friendship.
Hey, man, you know Friendship. The whole adage with them, man, consistency.
Yes.
You know, Coach Davis does a good job out there in Friendship with their program. And, hey, man, how about the kid Ronald Ewok, man?
Yeah, you know.
You were mentioning earlier about splitting time. He will be the man this year.
Yes, he will.
You know, I have an opportunity to visit with Ewok quite a bit. He's a great kid, man, and I wish the best for him this season. Hope and pray he stays healthy. And if he does, he's going to have a Friendship on the ball this year.
Yes, he will. Number two team to us is the Amarillo Golden Sandstorm, the Sandies. Mike Ortega, cornerback. Texas Tech commit, defensive end Ivory Jackson.
Wow.
How about Anthony Geiger returning? Mm. He ran for 1,000 yards and 13 touchdowns last year.
Yes, he did.
So their offense is intact. They're going to run, hit you right in the mouth. No excuses.
Yeah.
And that's what we like about Amarillo. And they'll finish number two. Now here's where it gets interesting, Vic. Number three. Is it Tascosa? Is it Monterey, Coronado? Give me your pick.
Hey, man, I'm going to go on the edge, and I'm going to say Monterey gets it done this year.
Monterey.
To that third spot,
Ooh.
You know. Man, you know, Coach Hussison coming into his second year over at Monterey, man. He's a great guy, great coach.
Yeah.
And he's doing a real good job with the Monterey Plainsman program, man.
Yeah.
The way he's that winning attitude and that pedigree he brings to that program, man, and it's starting to rub off, and those kids are buying into what he's selling over there, man.
That's right.
Hey, man, you know, Monterey will slide into that third spot.
That third spot, Baylor Mitchell at quarterback.
Yes.
It's your time.
You know,
Hunter Spaeth not there anymore, so we're going to expect a lot out of Baylor Mitchell. I think he's up for the task. He's been working hard all summer, 7-on-7 and things of that nature.
Yes.
He's looking like he's ready. Corbin Whitfield.
Yes.
Trent Ward at cornerback.
Mm-hmm.
And he's going to play some wide receiver this year is what his mom told me. So Trent Ward's going to be good.
Yes,
he was good last year.
Yeah.
He'll be first team all-district cornerback and maybe receiver also.
Yes, sir.
Let's jump into the fourth spot. Tascosa. Rebels. Coronado Mustangs. Give it to me.
Hey, man, I'm going to be biased. I'm going with the Coronado Mustangs sliding in at that fourth spot, sending two Lubbock 6A schools into the playoffs this year. Coach Parr coming in his second season.
Yeah.
Man, great pedigree once again.
Once again.
Brings a winning attitude. He's doing a real good job out there at Coronado, man, and I believe he will get them going in the right direction to get in the playoffs this year.
Well, when you got Christian Hayes, I feel like one of the top three versatile athletes in the 806.
Yes.
Got him, you got Zach Stepp at tight end. The best place kicker to me and Connor Dean.
Kicked
a 54-yard game when he gets Odessa Permian.
Yes.
And let's not forget, I think the tell of the tape in this district is quarterback play. You got Quay Gray, a sophomore.
Yes.
Who's going to start for the Mustangs.
Yes, he will.
I'm hearing a lot of good things about him.
Mm-hmm.
And if what we hear is true, Coronado's got talent all over the field. Emory Giddings, offensive line, Texas Tech commit.
Yes.
There's no excuse for them not to get him.
Yeah.
Let's talk about Tascosa, because to me, that's what you call a definition of a coin flip.
Yes,
because Tascosa could easily get in also. You know, you got Josiah Pennington at cornerback, Keyshawn Cervantes at linebacker. Tascosa lost a lot. They lost, Jacob Biggers, a great tailback quarterback for them in their offense. But they should be able to step in and be fine. But we'll run with that, you know. Friendship, Amarillo, Monterey, Coronado, Tascosa. And we'll see where we end up from there. Yeah. Let's jump into District 4-5-A.
Wow.
Man, you got Lubbock Cooper, Lubbock High, Abilene Cooper, Plainview, and San Angelo Lake.
Yes.
One team's out of the playoffs in that district. Who wins that district, Vic?
Hey, man, I'm going to go ahead and say Coach Cat Winkle and the Lubbock Cooper Pirates, man.
Okay.
You know, another growing school district, another growing program out there in Cooper. And Coach Cat Winkle does a great job with those young men, man.
Yes,
and they will be probably make a deep run. Let's say, state title contenders.
Yeah.
You know, out there at Lubbock Cooper. Because Coach Cat Winkle, I hate to keep mentioning his name, but he's such a good coach and a good guy.
Great.
You got to give him his love and his props, man. He does a great job.
I think that as far as Coach Cat Winkle is concerned, I think last year they underachieved a little bit.
Yes.
And not in a bad way. They got to the playoff second round, but I thought they would go deeper. This year, the addition of Jared Davis, changed things.
It did.
He's a great quarterback. Big size, 6'3", 190.
Wow.
He fits the part.
Yes, he does.
Seth Watts at tailback. Jordan Solis at wide receiver. Ty Thomas, linebacker. Kirby Vincent at defensive end.
Oh,
they got players all over the field and a great coach and a great community.
Yes,
they support those kids like no other.
Yeah.
Keep supporting them because they'll be 6A in a couple of years.
Yeah.
let's talk about Lubbock High and Coach Strong, one of our favorites on the show.
Mm-hmm.
I think they'll get in this year.
Yes, sir.
They'll beat San Angelo Lakeview head-to-head, and that'll get their playoff spot.
Yeah.
You know, they took a year off from making it last year, but they made it the year before.
Yeah.
Jacob Bayou, Day-Day Morgan, Devontae Greathouse. He's got some weapons, too. 16 starters back.
Yeah.
Give me a rundown, Lubbock High, and how do you feel about their chances this year?
Hey, man, Coach Strong, man, great guy, great coach. Had an opportunity to sit down, interview him, and talk with him a little bit, man, and I believe he's doing the right thing to get that program in the right direction. They will slide into that fourth spot and get into the playoffs and make a run this year.
I think so, too. I look down and I look at Plainview, and to me, they're the ultimate, you know, they're kind of a flip the coin team, too, because they can finish third. They can finish first.
Yeah.
Because Coach Rhodes, as you said, does a great job out there and loves his kids. You know, Warren Fly leaves, you think there's a gaping hole at tailback? No, there's not. Not with Trenton Jackson. T. Jackson, what he called himself on Twitter.
Yeah.
He's dangerous. Against Abilene Cooper, he ran for 168 yards and 4 touchdowns last year as a sophomore. He's a junior this year. Watch what he does.
Yeah.
And they stay with 4 or 5 tailbacks. I'm not mentioning a few, and I apologize, but they just don't have one at Plainview. They're going to keep coming at you in waves. You know, they finished tied for first in the district along with Abilene Cooper and Lubbock Cooper. I think Abilene Cooper finished second or third.
Yes.
And, of course, Lubbock High fourth in that district.
Yeah.
All right, let's jump into the most ballyhooed district talked about around here in the 806 area, District 14A. Our disclaimer, Victor Hatchett's son, Rakeem Hatchett Cooper, is on that staccato, is starting, is the captain, is a Dave Campbell's Texas High School Defensive Player of the Year in that district. Third team all state already. Great kid. Let's get into the district. Estacado had a lot of things going on last year. In the summer, starting in the two-a-days. Good, you know, for Coach Chavance. So give us a rundown, Estacado.
Hey, man, you know Coach Chavance. What can I say about this guy, man? Great person, great coach, man.
Yeah.
Been here 9 years.
Yeah.
9 playoff runs.
Yep.
And I believe this will be, they'll be a little young on offense because they lost quite a few seniors, a good group of kids last year, which I think, you know, kind of underachieved, should have went a little deeper, but you know, that's the way things work out in football.
Yep.
But I believe he'll bring back a young program that'll I believe they can make a deep run this year, man. A real good defense, returning 7 starters.
Yes.
They got a linebacker coming back, Sean Hastings.
Beast.
He went out with a knee injury last year. He's back this year, man. He's looking real good. And then, you know, you got good cornerbacks, Deontay Thomas.
Yes.
You know, Kobe Bracey.
Yeah.
Hey, man, those guys, they're going to be ready to go. It's going to be running real interesting to see what Estacada does this year. And also, How about this? Bringing in a new defensive coordinator this year.
Oh, wow.
This guy's been a long time. Coach Romero left, and he's done a great job over there in the years he was there. But, you know, you always got to have some new blood come in, and it's going to be interesting to see what he can get those young men to do over there.
Yeah. And my district defensive player of the year will be Marcel Woodard.
Wow.
From Estacado. Free safety headhunter. He will hit you in the mouth. He'll pick it off and take it to the house. He's an enforcer.
Yes.
You know, losing Papa and the Willard, you know, brothers back there in the secondary, you know, it hurt. But I think him back there, he is what they need.
Yeah.
He's rangy.
Yeah.
He's scary.
Yeah.
He's scary.
Probably looking at him, probably one of the best secondaries in 4A in the state of Texas.
Easily.
Man. Yeah.
Easily. And that was their weakness last year.
Yeah.
Obviously. Let's jump to Levelland.
Wow.
Got a new field.
Wow.
New helmet. New logo. A new wide receiver in Kenton Williams who hadn't played since his freshman year. Great basketball player.
Man.
Obviously. Took Bridgeport, who won the 4A state championship, to the wire with him out there.
Yeah.
And now he's going to play wide receiver.
Wow.
To add with Chandon Jones. To add with the best 4A quarterback in Texas. And I said it. Nick Gerber.
Yeah.
Dangerous. Dangerous team out there on offense. Isaiah Cortez, a linebacker on defense. Coach Sanderson, Coach Norman. Levelland's got something going out
there.
Yes,
they do.
Besides one of the best fields I've seen in a long time.
Yeah.
Golly, it was well overdue, as Coach told me. Well overdue, but hey, it looked good. It was worth the wait. What do you think about Levelland?
Hey, man, you know, you got to give Levelland respect, man. You know, they played Estacada down to the wire last year. Real good game.
Yeah, it was.
You know, they lost a good receiver in Jones. But hey, man, Nick Gerber, man, I got a chance to watch him, man. And now, you know, for all you old school football fans last year, that know football,
yeah,
he looked like Fran Tarkin. The way he moves around in that pocket and make things happen, man, it will be very interesting to see who will come out on top in that district, man. And I believe it'll come down to Thursday night here in Lubbock, Texas.
Oh, yeah.
Against the Estacada Mountain Boys to see who will win the district championship for 1-4-A.
What a game.
What a game.
There's a lot of positives about Levelland.
Yes.
Let's jump to one negative. 75 points they gave up in that playoff game in Abilene Wild.
Wow.
65 points they gave up against Estacado last year. 64 points they gave up against Borger, against Pampin, double overtime win.
Yes.
You can outscore a lot of people. When it gets to the playoffs, you got to start cracking down on defense.
Exactly.
Coach Sanderson knows that. So he's going to have some players playing both ways.
Yeah.
Hopefully it'll work out for them because they're going to put points
on
the board.
Yes, they
guarantee
are.
You that. Let's look at Pampa. You got Bryce Parker, Brandon Wafflow, you got Jason Thomas. I mean, Coach Pointer. Pampa, you know, kind of laying in the woods like, hey, don't forget about us.
Yeah.
I think they'll be fine this year in Harvester Nation.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm thinking they'll get the 3 seed. I'm looking at Seminole.
Yes.
What Coach Ken Jackson.
What about Coach Jackson?
Man.
Wonderful guy.
Hell of a coach.
Yes.
He's got a hell of a quarterback with him, too, in Brett Hicks. You know, you got Morgan Davidson, offensive line. I mean, they're set. You know, they lose Sabron Adams. To me, one of the best, you know, utility players that have came around for it.
Yeah.
Could play any sport, soccer, if you want to put him out there, volleyball. He's that good.
Yes.
He's gone. But Brett Hicks is a great quarterback, 3 for 9 touchdowns and 2 interceptions in his last 2 starts last year. Comes in a junior, and he comes in with a lot of expectations, but he's ready. His dad, Gregory, he's a great supporter, 806.
Yeah.
He says, watch out for my son, he's going to be good.
Yeah.
I know it. He's going to be good. They'll get the 4 seed. I think the team looking out, it'll be Borger.
Yeah.
And I hate to say that because Borger stays, you know, they run hard. Last year they got in the playoffs. They got beat 60-8. You know, by Andrews, but at least they made it in.
Yes.
And I think they're going to be a good team this year. They just lost too much.
Yeah.
You know, Julius Bumpus, he's going to be a first-team all-district cornerback.
Yeah.
He may be a second or third-team running back because I think the first team will belong to Estacado, probably all their running backs on the first team. They lost a couple, but they gained 3 more. That's how it works at Estacado to me. You know,
yeah.
They can shuffle whoever they want in. They're going to be in the playoffs.
Yeah.
They're a fixture. So when we come back on the 2-a-days preview, we'll jump into talking about 1-4-A district, you know, Division 2, Bushland, La Mesa. We'll jump into 3-A, talk about post. And we're going to get to every team, so just stay tuned with us. Jason Pearson, Victor Hatchett, 806 HSA TV, 2015, 2-a-days preview. We'll be right back.
All right, this is Jason Pearson, 806 HSSC, 2-a-day tour 2015. Lubbock Cooper, Coach Cat Winkle, one of the good coaches that support us, been supporting us since we had 1,000 likes. So I appreciate coming out here. So 2015, you know, you got a couple of great additions. You lost a couple of good players, you know, like Colton Ayers and the likes. So how would you assess your 2015 team coming in this year?
Well, we're excited about them because our senior class has been the class that's kind of been with us since we came in as a coaching staff. They played as sophomores on our varsity, and they're just a really strong class, not only athletically, but also just chemistry and leadership-wise. So we're looking forward to them having a great senior year.
I'm looking at your district. You got Lubbock High, Abilene Cooper, Plainview, San Angelo Lakeview. It's kind of tough last year. You know, I think it was a three-way tie, if I'm not mistaken. So when you look at your district, you know, who are you looking out for out there?
We look out for everybody, honestly. That's not just a coach saying, but really strong district. You know, Plainview is loaded once again. Abilene Cooper is as well. Lubbock High with all their returning starters and Coach Strunk's energy, they're going to be a handful. So we've got our work cut out for us every week, and we just got to get better every week.
Who could we be looking out for on some of your key additions for this team?
Well, you know, we've got some of those seniors we're talking about. Kirby Vinson's a three-year starter for us and a great leader. Josh Quinton on the inside, A.J. Perez at the corner. Those are just great athletes and great kids also. Offensively, of course, you know, Jarrett Dagey is a big threat for us, but we got Seth Watts and Jordan Solis back there as well to distribute the ball around. So we're excited. We feel like we're pretty balanced.
Yes, you are. Well, all right. I appreciate you for the interview, Coach Cat, and hopefully this year me and you will be talking late into November, early December.
I hope so, Jason.
Yes, sir. Have a great year.
Thanks.
Welcome to the 806 HSSC 2015 preview show, going over every team in the 806. Powered by 806HSSC.com and the mobile app. Don't forget to go get the mobile app. All the schedules, links, and GPS how to get to these fields. Sometimes it's hard to find. It's all on that mobile app, over 2,800 downloads. Let's keep that going. All right, let's jump into District 14A-D2. Bushland is there. Bushland is going to be a great team this year. So they have Cameron Mathis, great quarterback coming back, and they got an all-state tailback, and Boston Andrews back also.
Yeah.
So give me a rundown on Bushland in that district.
Hey, man, you know, Bushland, they was pretty tough last year. You know, they went 2-2 in their district. And 5-6 on the season. It'll be interesting to see what they can get done down there. Coach Thomas does a real good job with that program. And I believe Bushland will get in the playoffs and make a great stand this year.
I think so, too. And one thing I do like is their jerseys.
Wow.
Best jerseys and helmets in the 806, darn near. I mean, looking good.
Nice.
Let's jump into, is it 24AD2, which houses one 806 team that we watch exclusively, and that's the La Mesa Golden Tornadoes.
Yes.
Quarterback Heath Derrington's there.
Yeah.
Give us a rundown on La Mesa, who missed the playoffs last year, hoping for a little better this year. What do you think about that?
Hey, man, Coach Tim James does a good job. You know, they struggled last year. They went 1-9 last year. Kind of rough season, but you know, each year presents a new challenge.
Yeah.
And you hope that, you know, La Mesa can come in this year and do better than they did last year, and I believe they will. They got a real good coach down that way. Good group of kids. Quarterback coming back this year, Heath Darrington.
Yeah,
he did
good.
A great job for those guys last year, and it'll be real interesting to see what he can do to power that team forward.
Yeah, and let's jump into 3-3A. Division 2, which houses our only team in 806 out there with Cajoma and Coleman and Stanton. It's our post Antelopes.
Yeah.
Cambry Gilbert's back.
Yeah.
A.J. Reed's back. A.J. Reed ran for 1,000 yards and had 80 plus tackles last year, so they have 15 starters back.
Yes, they do.
So they sitting good over there at post. A lot of things happened to post last year. The school burned down. They got a new school. I mean, they still have the same great facilities, same great coaches. And we're rooting for Post. We will be there for their first game against Abernathy.
Yeah.
What a rivalry. They'll beat Abernathy on their new field, which we'll get into later. But give me a rundown on the Post Antelopes.
Hey, man, that kid Cameron Gilbert. You know, it's real interesting. I coached YFL for a long time.
Yes.
And I remember back in 2006, we were playing in the Super Bowl of the 10-year-old Falcons against the 10-year-old Dolphins, and Cameron Gilbert was the starting tailback for the Dolphins that year. And the kid's been great since, and he's continued to move forward and do a good job. And you wish the best for Post, because they went through a lot last year, and
yes,
we'll be
did.
Praying for you guys here at 806.
And I'll tell you one thing about Post. They showed their resilience last year. Hopefully all distractions aside, they're going to make a deep run this year. Yes, they came in ranked number 19 in 3A in the Texas High School Football Poll. So they should do good.
Yes.
When we come back off a break for the 806 2015 preview, we'll be jumping into 3A exclusively, 381, D2, Idaloo, Roosevelt, Brownfield, Shelly. We'll be right back on 806 HSSC TV.
High school sports fans, welcome back to 806 High School Sports Connection. I'm Victor Hatchett with my co-host Jason Pearson, and we're going to continue to give you the rundown of the Tour Day preview.
Yes, sir.
Hey, Jason, we're about to go over 1-3-A Division 1. Hey, give us a rundown on that district.
That houses, to me, a serious, legit state title contender in the MSU Mules.
Wow.
They lost their offensive defensive coordinator to Crane, but Coach Wood and his son, Wes Wood, offensive coordinator, they're not skipping a beat. You know, Phil Turingo for Lubbock Avalanche Jones said they looked real good against Idaloo in their scrimmage. And I went out there and watched. That was the first place I visited for my 2 days preview. They looked good.
Wow.
You know, Danny Campos, Beto Diaz was injured a lot last year, had a lot of bad luck, but he's back. He's a backup. He looks good. Brandon Mill, a great, great freshman they have at quarterback. He's been to over maybe 15 camps in the last summer. But Jason Flores, Josh Campos, they got a lot of dangerous weapons at MSU.
Yeah.
I also went out to Littlefield. Littlefield's looking good. Coach Huseman, Bryson Calloway. Me and Vic want to give our prayers up for Seth Clayton. He had a compound fracture in his arm in that scrimmage against Levelland. So prayers up for you, brother. Hope everything get better. We love Littlefield. Coach Huseman, one of the best coaches around in his 25th year.
Wow.
Here's a fun fact. You know, 10 of those years, whereas as a basketball coach. I didn't even know that he coached Littlefield basketball.
Yeah.
So Littlefield has tradition. You know, they went to the state final, you know, state title game in 2006, state semifinal in 2010. So Littlefield should be fine. So I'm looking at Childress also. Their JV went undefeated last year. All of them on varsity this year. You know, Bryce Bowman at quarterback, Blake Fry, wide receiver. So to me, those are our three, you know, solids. You know, then you'll get into Friona, you get into Dimmitt and River Road. What do you think about those teams, Vic Vibert, that last playoff spot?
Oh, it's going to be real interesting, man. You know, those teams were kind of at the bottom of the district last year, but, you know, every year presents a new challenge.
A new adventure.
You know, maybe one of those guys improved. It'll be interesting to see who will slip in and get those two last spots.
Ooh.
For the you look at Amarillo River Road, you know, they're real good. They run the wishbone offense.
Yes.
And they're bringing back quite a few good kids there.
Yes,
and
sir.
It'll be real interesting to see them. Hey, Steve Gunner over at Dimmitt, man. You know, they struggled last year. And, you know, second year coming in this year, I think he's going to improve that team, man.
Me too.
He works real hard with those kids over there.
Yes, he does.
It'll be real interesting to see what they can do. And then Friona, man. You can't count them out. You know, Coach Aries, he does a great job over there also.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
You know, it's going to be a real good, interesting. I think you better pay attention to that district for those last two spots, man. It'll be a real battle to see who gets in.
You know, one thing that I've learned that it's called, you know, seeing is believing.
Yes.
That's a hell of a quote because I saw Gabriel Chico when I went to see Friona. That's one of the biggest running backs I've seen in a long time.
Yeah, yeah.
How do you get out here to 3A that big?
Yeah.
Gabriel Chico's going to have a big year. Is it big enough to catapult Friona to the playoffs?
Yes, you're right.
Let's jump into 2-3-A.
Wow.
Division 1. Man, Shallow Water, ranked number 2 in the state. Brownfield, number 17 in the state. You also have Kermit, Slayton. There's a lot of teams in there. Who else is in that division?
And Tornillo. Denver City.
Denver City. Yikes.
Wow.
This division here, district to me, is... It's not a toss-up, I feel, but if Denver City overachieves, they could be right there at the 1.
Yeah.
I mean, I see them solid as the 3. I'm looking at the 1 and 2 slot here. Shallow Water's the real deal.
Yes, they are.
You know, they bring Cooper Ogle, second team All-State. Mm-hmm. As me and... What's funny, I was looking at our shows last year. Me and Victor predicted that Cooper Ogle would be second team All-State in week 4.
Yeah.
He was second team All-State.
Yeah,
he was.
Said
and done. He's that good.
He's that good.
He's got to be injury prone. He's got to stay away from the injuries. Chris Contreras, also a quarterback. Winston Elliott was going to be, you know, it's going to be a quarterback battle. He moves to Midland Christian. You got Chris Contreras by himself and Cooper Ogle. You know, they're one injury away from a problem, I feel. But if they can stay healthy, you know, they got Brendan Burgett, Jake Johnston. They got so many players on that team.
Yes, they do.
You know, they got Connor Smith, great wide receiver, and the best punter in the 806.
Yeah.
They got a lot of weapons for Coach Maxfield of Shallow Water.
Yes, they do.
Brownfield has the best young quarterback in Texas. In Texas.
Yeah.
And Jalen Nolan.
Yes, they do.
15. Smart. Learning from past transgressions from other players and other situations. That's what makes you a better player when you learn. This summer, he didn't do anything but worked out hard. Dad got him a weight room set in his backyard. We sponsored him to go to the Graham Harrell passing camp.
Yeah.
Heard he was one of the best passers out there.
Mm.
That little youngster is working, and it's for the team.
Yeah.
Kobe Cervantes is going to be a first-team All-District cornerback for Brownfield. Jezreel Griffin.
Yeah.
Dakota Oliver is center.
Mm-hmm.
Brownfield's back and loaded. Let's jump to Denver City. DC Pride.
Yeah.
Roll Red Roll. They're going to ride the train of Cole McElroy this year.
Yeah.
And hopefully he can take them to a playoff spot and deep in the playoffs. They lost last year to Brock when they went for a two-point conversion and didn't get it.
Yeah.
So Denver City's looking okay. You know, they got Aaron back there at the tailback. Bryce Brown, offensive lineman. They're looking good.
Yes, they are.
You know? And Vic, you know a little bit more about Slayton. As we went out there, you know, Coach Robinson went right there, talked to you for about 40 minutes. So give us a rundown on Slayton.
Hey, man, you know, Slayton, you know, they struggled last year. They went 3-7 on the season, 1-4 in that district. You know, that district is a real good district, man. And, and, you know, Coach over there, he does a great job. Coach Robinson, I had a chance to talk with him, man. He gave us a good rundown on that team.
Yes, he did.
And they got some interesting athletes over there.
Yes.
Got a transfer in from the local district. Got them out of doors. Avion Williams, 1-2. To his senior year, told us, hey, why did you come back to Slayton? He said, hey, man, I want to play with my brothers my last year of high school. And I thought that was a beautiful quote right there, man. And I got a lot of respect for that young man, his father. And it'll be real interesting to see what they can do over in Slayton this year.
Yeah.
I think they make a playoff run this season.
Me too. I think they'll get the 4 spot.
Yeah.
I see Kermit at the 5 and Tornillo They won one game last year. Tough, to me, it's tough for them having to drive back and forth 4 or 5 hours, or vice versa. One level two having to go 6 hours out there. So I think they'll miss the playoffs this year once again. Hopefully, realignment next year, they'll be back where they need to be.
Exactly.
You know, a little bit more comfortable.
Yes.
Let's jump into 1-3A Division Two.
Wow.
A dangerous district. You got Idaho in there, ranked number 15 in the state. Spearman, ranked number 12 in the state. You got Tulia, Sanford Fritch. They got a, you know, it's
Amarillo Highland Park.
High, you know, Roosevelt. Man, that's a heck of a district.
Yes, it is.
Let's go over our order predicted finish. I think it'll come down to the last game of the season again between Idaho and Spearman for 1 and 2.
Yes.
I think this year Idaho will get them.
Yeah.
Last year Spearman went into Idaho and won.
Yes.
I think this year Idaho will go into Spearman and win.
Yeah, wow.
When we looking at Idaho, Vic, give me a rundown of Idaho Wildcats. Three dangerous guys in the backfield.
Hey man, Coach Lofton.
Yeah.
Great job over at Idaho, man.
Coach Lofton.
You know, I love to say that throughout the show, man, because like I say, man, anytime you coach young men and you got a chance to mold those young guys, just so not about football but about life, period.
Yes.
And, you know, we got a lot of respect for every coach that take their time out of their families to do what they do. And, you know, it's going to be interesting. Idaho's always tough, man. Good program, man. Consistent every year. And it'll be real good to see what Idaho can do this year. Got them picked to win this district.
Yes. I mean, Zach Kirkpatrick, linebacker, quarterback. You got Brant Schilling, Ty Nichols getting D1 looks.
Wow.
D1 looks. He's that big and that good. And Idaho's going to bring it every year, hard-nosed.
Yes.
But Spearman has an all-state returning guard in Brandon Smith.
Ooh.
He'll pancake you on the offensive side, and he'll knock your quarterback in the next week on the defensive side. Peyton Smith playing quarterback this year. But let's talk about, to me, I call it the wild card team, and that's the Roosevelt Eagles.
Wow.
You got Cole Garrett and Isaiah Montgomery. To me, the best 1-2 punch in the 806.
Yes.
I mean, Cole Garrett came in and just lit the numbers up last year. And Isaiah Montgomery had 1,800 yards as a sophomore. In our interview, Coach Contrusi, you know what he told me? He said he thinks the defense will be better than the offense.
Wow. That says a lot.
That says a lot because their offense is good. Trey Bass, a wide receiver. He's a big boy, 6'3".
Yeah.
I mean, Roosevelt can, like I said, they can finish third or they can finish first because they're going to put points on the board.
Exactly.
Let's go to a game. They lost 61-21 to Spearman last year, right?
Yeah.
But he told me they had 4 touchdowns called back in the first half. So, I mean, just that's when you're at a game, you can really tell a story more. If it was a blowout, you know, or, you know, we may see that, but you never know what really happened unless you're at the game. And that was some great insight from Coach Contrusi.
Yeah.
I think Tulio will get that 4th spot.
Wow.
Ricky Johnson back, number 8, a tailback, 4 linemen back.
Mm-hmm.
It's a great team right there. You know, Sanford Fritch, you know, looking, you know, outside in. But that's a great district right there in 1-3A, and we're excited to see it unfold. You know, Spearman and Idaho and Roosevelt, their offense clicking. They're going to make some runs in that playoff.
Yeah.
And they need to be ready because they'll see the likes of Cisco, Eastland on the other end in the first round. That's tough. So when we come back off break, we'll be getting into the mighty, murderous, dangerous, scary 2A divisions. Victor Hatchett, Jason Pearson, 806 HSSC 2015 preview. We'll be back.
Hey, high school sports fans, welcome back to 806 High School Sports Connection. I'm Victor Hatchett with my coach, Jason Pearson, and we're going to continue to give you the 2015 two-a-day rundown.
Yeah.
Hey, Jason, we're about to jump into 1-2-A Division 1. Give us the rundown on that district.
The District of Champions has the state champion, the Canadian Wildcats, coming in as obviously the prohibitive favorite to repeat. I think they will.
Yeah.
You got Tanner Schaefer at the quarterback, best small school quarterback, getting real legit D1 looks, going to go D1. 51 touchdowns last year and only 6 interceptions.
Wow.
3,800 yards passing. Good quarterback. But with a good quarterback, you got to have a good wide receivers. There's Chance Cook, Sawyer Cook, Cameron Copley. They got a lot of weapons out there on that offensive side. They lose a little on defense. They lose Andrew Azell. He went to Baylor, walked on, got a scholarship at Baylor.
Wow.
So Canadian is rich, you know, thick, rich with tradition. They're going to be good again. Anything's possible, I feel, you know, in this district. They lost a lot on defense, but I just know how hard their coach is coaching. And if Max Preps ranks you number 2 in the nation,
that says a lot.
Let's talk about Wellington. The house is probably, you know, the top 2 running back tandem in 2A and Jose Tellis and DJ McKnight. DJ McKnight's a great utility player, great returner, fast in the backfield. One day I saw that up front live in a playoff game. Think they'll be good. I think they slide to number 2. Trevor Robinson also, he's 6'9", 260. He's only a freshman for Wellington. They had a feature story about him in Dave Campbell's Texas Magazine, how tall he is. Where did he come from? let's say the 3 spot. It could flip-flop 2 or 2. Stratford Elks, Gage Brooks, Ty Hess. I mean, I remember going to watch them in a playoff game against New Deal. And the way they did New Deal, you know, 47-21. They were up 26-0 at the end of the first quarter.
Wow.
I was very shocked. But Stratford is, you know, just stoked in tradition. A great team. Great color, blue and white.
Yeah.
So, and let's not forget, in 2A, don't forget, Vic, this year, guys, in 2A, 4 playoff spots now. Not 3 in a bye. Mm. Only 4, and the number 1 seed is going to play now.
Yeah.
And that's good news for the Panhandle Panthers, because I think they'll get that 4th spot. Edging out Stinnett, West Texas, and edging out Boys Ranch. So that's our predicted order finish. I feel Canadian, Wellington, Stratford, it's a toss-up there, 2 or 3. And then you'll have Panhandle get in as a 4 seed. Give us a rundown on that district of champions.
Hey, man, I can't disagree with anything you've said. Man, you know, the Canadian guys, wow. What a program down that way, man, to go and win the state championship last year. And the possibility to backdoor it again this year.
One more time.
Going down, Houston, we have a problem. You know, hey, the state championship will be played in Houston, Texas this year. It won't be in Dallas, so you got a little further to travel. But, hey, you never mind traveling that anywhere when it comes time to put on a ring.
To y'all just been saying, you go to get that ring, I'll go 10 hours to get that ring.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
All right, let's jump into 2-2A Division 1. And now me and Victor both know those are cross matches. So the 1-4 there will play the 1-4 there. They'll match up and play Abernathy. New field, beautiful field.
Yes, it is.
Man, Coach Daly, I mean, this team here, man, you know, Trey Bender's going to be the quarterback, was a receiver last year. Sawyer Knight coming off injury, was all district the year before. He's back. Some new move-ins. They're going to be good. Xavier Herrera at defensive end.
Wow.
6'4", 280.
Yes.
Junior? Gosh. You know, Abernathy will be good. You got New Deal. Jackson Durham taking over, baby, being a quarterback. John Manahan taking over the Jackson brothers. You know, you have Dane Hensley, Austin Pena at the offensive lineman. Dane Hensley was first team all-district center last year.
Yeah.
So they're going to be fine. Floyd Data, Kai Baker, is going to take over a quarterback this year. Talked to Coach Bandy on a two-a-day preview, said he expects a lot of him. He's got all the tools. I think they'll be okay also.
Yeah.
And then, as we say, when they open up the 4 slot, that's another good news for Hell Center.
Yeah, it is.
I think Hell Center gets in the playoffs this year. I really do. You got DJ Dunn at quarterback. DJ Dunn's a heck of a player. He threw for 5 touchdowns against Abernathy last year.
Mm-hmm.
Hell Center's going to be a lot better than people think.
Yeah.
Vastly improved. A great team out there. Mm-hmm. And they're going to give folks some trouble. You just can't slot them in at the 4. They might end up at the 3 or the 2, depending on how their offense does.
Yeah.
You know, that district is ultimate toss-up. You know, I'd like to say Abernathy, but then again, New Deal can win that district.
You never count out the line.
You can't count them out. Then you have on the back end there, Olten and Tahoka.
Yeah.
Tahoka's still working. I saw them last night against Seagraves. They got a little work to do. But they're, you know, Coach Hopper, you know, they're trying to turn it around. So yeah. Bulldogs will be okay, just may not make it this year again either.
Yeah.
And Olten, they're looking good, but I don't know if they get in. Maybe their matchup against Hssc determines that fourth playoff spot.
Yeah.
Give me a rundown on that district right there.
Hey, man, like you said, it's a toss-up in that district. You know, Abernathy, New Deal. Always great programs. Anybody can slide into that one spot.
That's right.
And, you know, with them taking four teams in, they should let the chips fall where they may and let them battle it out and see who can get it done.
That's right.
Yeah.
Let's jump into 3-2A Division 1.
Yeah.
That houses Booker, Groover, Shamrock, Claude, Wheeler.
Yeah.
You know, that division there, Booker lost a lot. Jared Reagan, you know, all-time, you know, leading receiver in the state of Texas.
Yeah.
In the state of Texas. Let me say that again. Hunter Lyle, quarterback. You know, it's going to be hard to, you know, lose that. But you got Tristan Guzman at wide receiver. They got some talented, skilled players. Steve Taylor, the coach. It'll be fine. Groover's always good. The Greyhounds are always good.
Yeah.
You know, looking at Shamrock, they got a couple of prime players. I mean, that district there is kind of a toss-up. Give me a rundown on that district.
Hey, man, you know, they got Sunray picked to win it. But, yeah, you know, you never know, man. You know, injuries play a key part in every season.
Yes, they do.
And you hope and pray that no kid gets injured. But, you know, it just, you never know how it's going to go. And you wish all those teams well in that district. And I just want to sit back and watch how it go, man. It's going to be real interesting to see them take those four slots in that district.
That's right. They won a Division II. Man, that D2, all of them schools are scary.
Yeah.
You know, we're just now, you know, doing the tip of the iceberg, as I might say.
Yeah.
So when me and Victor come back off break, we'll jump into our last segment, previewing the last, you know, three districts in 2A D2, which houses one team we think should have won the state title last year. May get it done this year. Victor Hatch, Jason Pierce. We'll be right back.
Hey, high school sports fans, welcome back to 806 High School Sports Connection, the two-a-day preview. I'm Victor Hatchett with my co-host Jason Pearson. We're going to continue to give you the rundown for 2015 two-a-days.
Yeah.
Jason, we're about to jump into District 2-2A Division 2.
Mm.
Give us a take on that.
My take on that is it's going to be a battle, I feel, between Farwell and Vega. You know, Vega's got Justin Joyce. Vega's a team to beat.
Yeah.
To me, they got a lot of more, you know, teams you can't sleep on this year. A lot more players, a lot more continuity. They bring a lot of players back. Now Farwell, you know, they have Gerardo Martinez. He will be a first team All-State 2A, or at least All-District, second-team All-State. Got Adrian Allman, great tailback, ran for 1,500 yards last year. Mm. What will they do at quarterback?
Wow.
Losing J.J. Herrera, who's at Wayland, made the travel team, his dad said. Mm. Shout out to Sammy Herrera also, man. He's a great friend of the program, what we're doing. He's poured us 120%.
Yes, he does.
But losing J.J. is a big deal. They say Tadley's going to take over quarterback. It will depend on him, how he does, to see how far Farwell goes this year. Sudan, I went out there. Sudan looks good. Steven looking good at quarterback this year. He's back. You know, I see them maybe slipping in, getting the playoff spot this year and overtaking Spring Lake Earth. Spring Lake Earth lost a lot.
Mm.
You know, losing Elijah Ramon was big already. You know, I think they may be on the outside looking in. Bovina, losing Joseph Casas at quarterback. Bovina, you know, that's a big loss. You know, they're stoked in tradition also, but Casas is, it's a tough player to lose.
Mm-hmm.
And he made the travel team at Wayland. You know, those small schools got some good players
in there,
man.
Yes, they do.
So, I think, you know, the one team that may miss the playoffs in there will be Spring Lake Earth. I see Bovina, Farwell, Vega.
Yeah.
You know, and Sudan making the playoffs in there. What about, let's look at 3-2-AD2.
Wow.
3-2-AD2, you know, Crosbyton last year ran away with that district. Looked good. Lost in the state quarterfinals to Seagraves. They returned Timothy Childers. So, all the people that were tired of the Childers, get ready for three more years. Maybe a few more after that. Timothy Childers is a great tailback.
Yes, he is.
He's a sophomore. He's a heck of a kid. He's going to be playing linebacker also. But let's not forget about Elliot Rios. He's back.
Mm.
Elliot Rios runs hard. They got the hard and the soft package to me at tailback. And also Tanner Clark at quarterback. Mm-hmm. Looked like he's been working because he came in kind of thick this year.
Yeah.
Man, and they got all their offensive linebacks. So do not sleep on a Crosbyton Chieftains. I'm going right back to the state quarterfinals, I feel.
Yeah.
Ross looked good, has a new coach out there. I went to watch them on 2-a-days.
Yeah.
They look, Coach Caffey, look like he's trying to get them together. They're going to pass a lot more, he said. You know, or at least incorporate it more.
Mm-hmm.
Think Lockney will get the third spot. Or Quan will get the third spot. And Lockney will get the fourth spot.
Yeah.
Think Clarendon and Memphis might miss the playoffs. Memphis made it last year.
Yeah.
They lost a lot of players. Just a tough district to call besides the top. Phil Crobbington's going to win that district again.
Yep.
Coach Rogers has him ready to roll.
Mm-hmm.
And Quanta upset Booker. Maybe that was the upset of the year last year. It's been 2A. Knocked him out of the playoffs. So the Pujas and the Indians look like they're ready to make some noise.
Yeah.
I think the team, like I said, I think Memphis will be out this year. Remember, there's no bye, so everybody's going to play. So let's jump into 4-2-A. Wow.
Division 2.
Big, give me a rundown on Seagraves and what happened last year. What do we expect from them this year?
Hey, man, that team should have won the state championship. I'll say that, man. You know,
bottom line.
They should have won the state championship. But, you know, Coach Hereford, hey, he bring back another good team, man. And, you know, what about
19
that?
Stars.
Wow. And what about that running back they got?
Is it Corey Kyle?
Man, that kid is special back. And get to come back and play another season.
Yes, he does.
Wow, if he do anything that he did last year, man, he'll end up as probably top 4, top 5 running back of all time.
Of all time.
State of Texas.
When you say all time, that's a lot of players. But when you look at Seagraves, when I watched him a couple of times, I watched him in the scrimmage against Tahoka. Let's not forget about Pignon.
Mm.
Pignon had a receiving touchdown, rushing touchdown, 2 sacks,
God.
Crushing blocks. You got Quay Williams on the defensive end. He had interceptions. Skylar Clark, the energizer. 3 interceptions in that scrimmage.
Mm.
Skylar Clark is the juice that makes them go.
Yeah.
He is a very energetic player. Very, very team-oriented player. Wants the best for everybody. When he's on the sideline, he's screaming louder than he is playing.
Mm.
I like that.
You gotta love that.
Quest Williams, Joseph Guerrero is gonna be starting off ill. I mean, it's still a battle from him and Uriel. I think he's got a little slight edge. He might win it. The quarterback position is going to determine a lot of things for Seagraves. Seagraves in their first team offense said, as you know, scrimmage is 15, 15, 10, 10. They have 15 plays. And Seagraves had 13 passing plays.
Wow.
So obviously, Coach Herford is working on a passing game, trying to make it where he's not predictable. You're not going to, and I was telling the players on the sideline, they might have got better from last year. And I didn't see how that was possible, but you introducing the pass, mm-hmm. passing more, you're not going to be able to just go up there and put nine in the box, try to stop Corey, because now they're going to pass the ball.
Yeah.
They're going to need a lot from Joseph Guerrero this year. But the defense is lights out.
Yes.
Lights out. Yeah. They're going to be fine. Uriel back there in the defense is unquestioned leader out there.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to be good, man.
Yeah.
Corey Kyle playing free safety. He'll light you up, too.
Yeah.
So, in that district, you know, Sundown's going to be good. Drew Berry's back at linebacker and tailback. Coach C. Smith, great coach, coming from Post his second year.
Yeah.
Sundown's going to be a force to be reckoned with.
Right.
I think Smart's going to get in the playoffs again. And I think Morton gets in this
year.
I think Morton slides in this year.
Wow.
Plains, Coach Chad Terry, his first year. Plains coming on from Slayton. He's going to have a rough go of it.
Yeah.
But he's in it for the long haul. You wouldn't have took that job, obviously.
You're right.
So, I think, you know, plans will be outside in, but Seagraves will get in. It's going to be, like I said, no breaks. Everybody plays, no buys, and that helps or hurts. You know, I had asked Coach Dale about that. He said, if you're winning on the road, you kind of want that. You know, you want to keep playing. But when he was hurt last year, you know, he wanted to get Nick Clarkson and the likes healthy. So, the bye, is, you know, so it's kind of a toss-up on the bye, but we kind of knew that was coming.
Yeah.
They were going to make him play. So, you know, all these teams, you know, I feel like there's a, you know, few teams that are legit state title contenders, and we'll talk about that after. But let's jump into a tap school. Let's jump into Trinity Christian.
Wow.
You know, Trinity Christian, give us a rundown on their coaching staff, star-studded coaching staff at Trinity Christian.
Man.
Making the turnaround.
Wow. Rodney Blackshire.
Whoa, Rodney Blackshire from Tech?
Yeah, Texas Tech great.
Oh, wow.
Head coaching that program over there, man. You know, wow. I think they're coming into the second year. It's going to be real interesting to see what he can do with that program. Coach Blackshear is a good coach.
Damn good coach.
And I believe he'll turn Trinity around. How about the defensive coordinator, Trey Ivory?
Big Trey.
Big Trey Ivory.
Woo!
Great football mind.
Yes, yes. Great
football mind, man. And I believe what he brings to the table with his knowledge of the game. Trinity has a bright future.
Yes, they do.
Coming in football. And also the secondary coach, Corey White.
Corey.
Wow, another great football
line. Eastern Mexico.
Yes, star. All-American at Eastern New Mexico at cornerback. Bringing in, man, I'm talking about he went out, I think Coach Blackshear went out and done a great job picking these guys to come on his coaching staff. And it will be real interesting to see what Trinity Christian does this year and which direction that they head. And I think it's a great direction.
I'll tell you right now, as far as Trinity Christian goes, you know, they may lose some games. You know, trying to get the football program, it's only second year. They still don't have a home field secured yet.
Yeah.
But, man, they're going to be ready athletically and mentally.
Yeah.
Because Coach Ivory will get you ready. He's going to work you. But one thing I like about Coach Ivory, he's going to work with you.
Yeah.
He's not going to be the coach that making you do all his hard stuff and stand on the sideline. He's going to be right there with you doing everything you do. And maybe trying to do a little harder than you.
Yeah.
That's the type of coach I want to play for.
Yeah.
We come back out break, we'll go over our top five teams that have a legit state title chance. Remember, it's early. Everything happens, you know, during the season, so we may be wrong, but we're going to put it out there anyway because that's what we do.
Yeah.
Victor Hatchett, Jason Pearson, 806 HSSC TV.
Hey, high school sports fans, welcome back to 806 High School Sports Connection. I'm Victor Hatchett with my co-host Jason Pearson, and this is our last segment for the 2015 Two-A-Day edition.
Yeah.
And we're about to give you the top five state championship contenders out of the 806. Jason, who will go to Houston? Because we don't want a problem down that way.
We actually did six. I just added a team right now.
Yeah.
Because I'm looking here, Muleshoe and Shallow Water, and I have to put them together.
Yeah.
Because they're going to play each other probably and knock one another out.
Yeah, yeah.
That's
yeah,
tough. Yeah. But Muleshoe, from all accounts and from what I saw, they're fast.
Yeah.
And they're scary this year. Danny Campos is back. If he can stay healthy, look like he's cutting down on the interception. Josh Campos, a dangerous defense. Jason Flores. Great coaching. This might be Muleshoe's year.
Yeah.
This might be their year. And I kind of feel like last year when they lost to Breckenridge, they should have won that game. They maybe came in too confident. As Coach Wood said, I walked in on them doing an interview with the players for the start before, you know, the first official practice. He said they shouldn't have lost to Breckenridge.
Wow.
And I thought so too, you know. And like he said, being good ain't good enough.
That ain't good enough.
It's not.
I thought that was a great quote too.
What a quote, man. And let's talk about shallow water. You know, I felt like they already had a lot of things to play for, because I felt like they could have beat Manola. They just got jump started late, as we talked about in our final show. And the, you know, the passing of Chavo in the summer. You know,
man,
to his family, you know, may God be with y'all. And, but for them guys to take that on, justice for Chavo, and you know, they're playing the season for him. They didn't need anything else to play for. To play for that,
man.
The weapons they have, the coaching they have.
Yeah.
Shallow water's ready. Experience. I mean, just to return all the offensive line and Cooper and Christian Trares.
That's big.
That's big time. We're going to find out if they're state title ready when they see the Estacado Matadors in week 3 or week 4.
Yeah.
Early.
Yeah, that'll be a good
That's going to be a great test for both teams.
Yes, it will.
So, that's why I put them two together. Vic, give me a... What do you think about these two teams and them having to knock each other out to get there?
Well, that's unfortunate for the 806, but you know, you only can have one champion.
Yeah.
And I'll say, man, you know, that's going to be interesting to see right there, man. I'm just going to sit back and I'm not going to make no prediction. I'm going to just sit back and let it unfold, man, and you wish both programs the best moving forward.
That's right. Don't forget, guys. Sorry we didn't talk about team enough or whatever, but we root for everybody.
Yes, we do.
And there's one thing you got to understand. When you're champions, you're going to get talked about more.
Yeah.
So the folks that are mad about, we talk about Canadian or Seagraves or Shallow Water, they win all the time.
Yes, they do.
You know, Shallow Water won 44 games the last 4 years.
Wow.
Didn't know that, did you? Mm-hmm. But you got to understand that. That's even in the media. When the Cowboys are winning, guess what? Cowboys are going to get talked about more than everybody.
Texas Tech,
Raiders, Yankees. When certain teams are winning or champions are winning, they're going to get talked about.
Yes, they are.
And when you're not, that's just how it goes.
Yeah.
You know? But let's jump into our second team, Seagraves Eagles.
Wow.
I feel like they're already addressing their concerns from last year, opening up the passing game.
Yeah.
And, you know, for them to go 13 plays out of 15 with their first team and not only rush Corey twice,
yeah,
shows me that they know what they want to do.
Exactly.
Those blackout uniforms are unbelievable, man. Coach Herford, man, he keep the boys looking good at Seagraves, man.
He does.
Corey Kyle. Quess Williams, you know, Joseph Guerrero, Yuri Martinez, Pignon, Quay Williams. I mean, one thing you got to understand about these players, and I'm saying this to all players, man, is winning a championship is okay, but being a champion off the field is what you really want to be.
There you go. Yes, sir.
Guys, make sure you're taking care of that classroom.
You gotta do that.
Because it's not the physical to me with Seagraves. It's not on the field. You guys can beat anybody, including Albany and Bremen, if you play them in a semifinal or the final.
Yeah.
Can you be model citizens off the field? Can you be great students, great, you know, for the classroom?
Helping the teacher
all the way around, man.
At home. Gotta obey your parents.
Obey your parents.
Gotta respect your elders.
Respect your elders. Because just because you can play football doesn't mean anything.
That's just a small part of life.
That's 5%, man. Being a respectable human being out here in the community, helping out, respecting your elders, Vic said, is what's going to determine really how you were judged in the end.
Yeah.
You know? But I feel like they had the tools to win it. Coach Herver's working on it. And they're going to be good, man.
Yeah.
I mean, their second team is good as 90% of the first team players out here.
Yeah.
So, that's another state title contending team. Let's talk about the Friendship Tigers.
Wow.
I just threw them in there. You know, I threw them in there because they have so many starters back, man. And they're going to win that first round game because they're going to have it at home.
Yeah.
In People's Bank Stadium. They don't lose there.
Nah.
So, they're going to be back where they were last year. Back with some hell of a players.
Man.
I mean, Tristan Kennard at quarterback, Ronald Awad at tailback, Hayden Harrison, Bryce Kaiser, Broderick Harrell.
On and on and on.
It's time. And when I went out there and watched him coach, I'm sorry I don't know his name, but he was coaching the line and linebackers. Boy, he wasn't playing.
Serious business.
And that's what they need, man. Friendship can live up to the expectations this year.
Yeah.
which segued me to my fourth team, and that's the Lubbock Cooper Pirates. Lubbock Cooper will play Friendship in week three.
Wow. What a game. What a matchup.
Lubbock Cooper's got a chance. They underachieved last year. I mean, let's not forget they were up 14-3 in the area round against El Paso Duval and got outscored 29-goose the rest of the game. Mm. You know, Jared Dagey makes a big impact.
Yes,
but is Jared ready for prime time?
Yes.
Because this is not 2A, Jared. This is 5A.
Another level of football.
Another level of football. We're not saying you're ready. I think you're ready. I think you're going to succeed and overachieve. You got great coaches around you and great players. Jordan Salas and Seth Watts on offense. Yeah. Defense, Kirby Vinson, Ty Thomas. You guys are looking good out there.
Yeah.
A.J. Ramirez at cornerback had 7 picks last year. Mm. So Cooper's got the real talent and you know, the moxie to get it done.
Yes, they do.
They can get it done. Yeah. You know, that level of Cooper Friendship games early, but that'll tell a lot. And then don't forget, the week after that, they see Stephenville on a Saturday.
Wow. Woo! Another great matchup.
Talk about great, you know, scheduling. Yep. Idaloo.
Got to give Coach Catwinkle a lot of credit,
Coach
man.
Catwinkle
he does a great job in getting those guys prepared and getting that stiff competition to get them prepared for that nice championship run.
Because that district tough, too. Abilene Cooper.
Yeah.
Abilene Cooper's going to be something to be reckoned with, too.
Yeah.
Let's jump into our last team, and I saved them for last because they're the most solid team, I think, to win, and that's the Canadian Wildcats. Canadian Wildcats.
Wow.
You win. You know, you go out there, state championship game against Mason, they score the first touchdown, and you score 34 and answer points on it.
And not a lot of a champion.
Nah. And you know what game stuck out to me last year? When, remember they beat Stratford in the first game in the district, 56-35.
Yeah.
I came on the show for the state quarterfinal, said Stratford was going to win.
Yeah.
I did. Mm-hmm. And Canadian beat them 35-0.
Mm.
Nothing. They didn't even get a touchdown.
Wow. How about that defense?
That defense was real.
Yeah.
And their offense is explosive. I mean, a quarterback with Copley and both the Cooks back, Schaefer, they're going to be ready to go, man. Mm-hmm. Coach Cuddy, you know, they're set, man. And ranked number 2 in the nation is, that's something I've never seen. The Lubbock team, or not 806 team, more Amarillo, Panhandle-ish. Ranked number 2 in the nation? Are you kidding me? They on the map like that?
Wow. Mm. That's great exposure, too.
Yeah, I mean, and they're going to have to earn it because I think this year, you know, I think they'll see Stratford down the line again in the playoffs. You can see Abernathy down the line in the playoffs, a new deal.
Yeah.
And I think this time, because don't forget Mason upset Refugio. I think Refugio will be waiting on him this time.
Yeah.
All right, guys, that'll conclude our show. Make sure to go to the mobile app, 806-HSSC. It's in the iTunes, Google Play, over 3,000 downloads or close to it. We got all the team schedules. We got all the GPS to your football fields, phone numbers, links to your school's website. So y'all make sure to go support there. Go to support 806hssc.com, the website. So subscribe, man. We got a lot of stuff for you guys on there for Gold and Silver members. And thank y'all for y'all support. You know what's funny? Today marks our, you know, second year, I guess. Started in 2013. This is the second, starting our third full year coverage. So thank you guys. You know, been a long way. So
yeah.
Vic, take us home, man.
Hey, guys, don't forget to tune in next week for our top 10 games of the week going into the season and our top players of the week. And we appreciate you guys watching.
Yeah.
And just continue to follow us. And we support all kids. And we love all you guys in the 806. And y'all have a good evening.
Thank you.